Hello guys, I am Sriram from Aptitude Adda. We are experts in company-specific trainings. You know, everybody is confused with what is Capgemini's 2021 new pattern. So here in this video, I am going to explain you Capgemini 2021 latest pattern along with the examples. In this video, I am going to explain what is pseudocode, verbal ability and game-based cognitive ability aptitude test. What are the different modules we have in that? What are the different subsections? What type of questions we get? What type of games we get? How to play with them, along with some examples. The same for behavioral competency profiling test also. The models, expected questions, types, along with some examples. Probably this is the first and clear cut video in internet, in YouTube, based on Capgemini 2021 new pattern. So guys, please subscribe to our channel and don't forget to share with your friends also. Let us start with the pattern. Capgemini is conducting total 3 rounds to select a candidate this year. Now, the first round is written assessment and second one is technical round followed by HR round.
In written assessment,
total we have 4 steps. One is pseudocode, second one is MCQ based English ability test, and third one is game based aptitude test, and fourth one is behavioral competency profiling test. So what is this pseudocode? Now, pseudocode is a combination of different programming questions. Probably they will be MCQs only. There will be 20 MCQs and 20 minutes of time will be there. It was previous time period, but this year it may change us, may not change us. So these questions are like, you know, you will get some theoretical questions from C language, C++, Java, database, you know, data structures. Okay. And some questions are like, you know, those are also MCQs only, but one program will be given and you have to check where the error is, or else sometimes you have to check what can be the possible output of the particular program. So these type of questions comes under pseudocode. And verbal ability test, normally it was writing an essay last year, but this year it will be multiple choice questions only, and hopefully there will be 20 questions as well, and 20 minutes time period will be given for this. No, it's assumption only, not yet clear. Okay, and what can we expect in verbal ability test? Now, probably those questions may be error detections, fill in the blank positions and conjunctions, and jumbled sentences. We have to arrange them in a particular order to make a meaningful sentence. And the questions can be based on parts of speech, and finally antonyms, synonyms are very important, of course. And what is third round? That is game based aptitude. So this game based aptitude is a new trend in hiring process. Now we call it as cognitive ability test also. What is this cognitive ability, or cognify round, or else gamify round, or else game based aptitude test? Okay, see, in this Capgemini especially, we have total 4 subsections. Now I'll explain each and every section in details after 2 minutes. Okay, so these 4 sections will be given in the game based aptitude test in Capgemini 2021. Okay, and if you observe, these are, the first one is deductive logical thinking, and second one is inductive logical thinking, third one is grid challenge, and fourth one is motion challenge. So what is this deductive, inductive, motion challenge and grid challenge? Let us see now, along with the examples, how to solve those questions. Deductive logical thinking is a type of Sudoku where numbers are replaced by symbols. The total time period for this section is 6 minutes. In these 6 minutes, you have to solve as many problems as you can. The more number of problems you put correctly, those many points you get. This is a simple example you can see in deductive logical thinking. Here you can find total 4 types of symbols, and you can see a 4x4 block. Here 4 are rows, 4 are columns. Now, these 4 symbols has to be arranged in the row wise without overlapping with the columns. Let me explain the same problem in detail here. If you observe, this is a 4x4 block. 1, 2, 3, 4 are rows. 1, 2, 3, 4 are columns. Here we have to find out which symbol will come in this question mark place. I'll explain the rules here. For example, if you see a triangle here, this triangle should not appear in the same row again. That is first row at the same time. This triangle should not appear in the same column again. So for example, if a triangle is here, sorry, if a rectangle is here, this rectangle should not happen in this place, similarly here also. At the same time, in this column, this rectangle should not be here, should not be here. So that is the second rule. By using these two rules, we can conclude like, if a symbol is here, the same symbol should not happen in the same row and column again. So rows and columns should not be overlapped. Okay, in that way, we have to check what is the key place in this problem to find out the answer. No, here remember you can answer all the, you can fill the, all the blocks, or else you may not fill. But ultimately you have to fill this particular place. Even if you fill all these places except this question mark, you will not get any mark. And at the same time, if you, even if you don't fill all these places, if you fill only this place, you will get the mark. So this is the only block which gives you a point. As soon as you start the test, a timer will run at the top corner. Okay, and now 6 minutes time will be there, and whatever the time you take to solve the question, timer runs and you have to solve as many problems as you can. And one more thing here, even if you put a right answer or wrong answer, you will not get any negative mark, but it is recommended that you should not click blindly all the options. Okay, no random answers. Now let me explain very clear how to solve this problem. See, here the logic is, you can find with this simple example. Here in this column, in the first column, here we have only one block, one blank place. You can fill this blank place easily. So what can be the symbol here? Check, we have these four are the possible symbols we have in this question. Already circle is here, triangle is here, plus is here. So we remain with square. So this place can be filled with a square. Now, forget about this column. Look at this first row. Here we have a square plus circle, and this is the blank one. We have square, we have plus, we have a circle. So we remain with a triangle. So this question mark should be filled with a triangle. So now what you have to do is, you have to click on this option. Remember, if triangle is right, if as soon as you click the correct option, you know, as soon as you click the option, if it is correct answer, it turns into green, and within fraction of seconds, next question will be displayed. If it is wrong answer, then it turns to red color, and in fraction of seconds, next question will be displayed. So by the time of clicking the option, you will get to know whether your answer is right or not. But we can do nothing, whether it is right or not, next question will be displayed in the fraction of seconds. So let me explain with another example. See, remember, you may get a 4 by 4 block, or else you may get a 5 by 5 block also. And you know, in 6 minutes hardly you can solve from 15 to 20 questions. And in these 15 to 20 questions, first 4 or 5 questions will be 4 by 4 block, and then after you will get 5 by 5 block questions. Those are a bit difficult than the 4 by 4 block. Let me explain an example with 4 by 4 ones and 5 by 5 ones. So in this example, you can see a triangle here and triangle here, plus here, square here, and a circle here. Now we have to find out which symbol comes in this question mark place. So if you look at the problem, just find which is the key symbol here. As we have two triangles, this might be the key symbol in this question. Okay, now let me place all these triangles in the each row. Okay, triangle is here, triangle is here, and we should have one triangle in this row and in this row. If you look at this problem, okay, look at third row, triangle can be here, triangle can be here, triangle can be here. We don't know if we look at only row. But when you compare the columns, as we already have a triangle in the second row, second column, we cannot place a triangle in third row of second column. Similarly, as we already have fourth column of the fourth row, one triangle, we cannot place a triangle in fourth column of third row. So remove this one also. Now we have only one place left with, we cannot place triangle here, we cannot place triangle here. So the only place we have for triangle is first column of the third row. So I placed triangle here. And you may have one doubt, in examination, while attending the assessment, you cannot draw all these questions on your notebook, no? So for that reason, we have an option, you know, a default option given by the examination platform. that when you take your mouse pointer to this blank place, when you take your mouse pointer to this blank place, all these four options will be displayed just above the pointer, and you can select any of those and that symbol will be appear here so that you can fill other blank places also. Okay, and don't worry, I'll show you an example after solving this question. Next one, so triangle is here. Now in this row, triangle is already in this place, so it can be the remaining one circle only. And if you look at the triangle, the only column that don't has triangle is third one. And of course triangle can be here, triangle can be here, but already we have one triangle in this place, so we cannot place triangle here. Already we have one triangle here, so we cannot place this one. So the only place we have for triangle is the question mark place. So this will be a triangle. So when you click on this triangle, it turns blue, it turns green. Now let me explain another example with 5x5 matrix block. Here you can find a 5x5 block and you can find a new symbol here, star. As we have more symbols in the second row, we will concentrate on second row, and we have to find out a this place value, you know, this place symbol, right? Look at the second row, we already have plus, we already have triangle and star, so we remain with only plus and sorry not plus we remain with a block, I mean a square and a circle, right? Now look at the first column. Already we have a block here, block in the sense a square here, so we cannot put a square in this place. So obviously it must be a circle and it must be a block so that we can fill second row. And now come to second column. In the second column we already have a triangle, a square, a star, so we remain with one plus and we remain with one circle. And if you observe the fifth row, we already have a plus symbol here, so we cannot put plus again in the same row. So it should be a circle. So obviously the only symbol we remain with in the second column is plus. So this plus symbol will be the answer. When you click on this, it turns green and next question will be displayed. So as we cannot remember these three symbols, so while solving, just to place these three things, default option will be there, and you can see that default option, how to use it in this video. Before going to the second section, if you are a TPO or a faculty of a college, please feel free to contact me to conduct a free webinar exclusively for your students. And if you are a student, please speak with your management and I am ready to conduct a free webinar for you and for your friends also. And don't forget to register yourself with Aptitude Adda to get more updates about Capgemini and other company drives. And I mentioned registration link in the description below. The second section is inductive logical thinking. Actually, I did a lot of research to find out the modal questions in inductive logical thinking, and finally I got two types of logical inductive modal questions. So let me explain the most popular one first, and then second one, probability is there but I'm not sure with that. So in the first modal, so if you look at this question, we have a question and option grids. In questions we have two grids, a 3x3 matrix, you can see a 3x3 grid, you can see and options also we have total four options, the same 3x3 grids only. Now what we have to do is we have to look at the question grids, and there is something relation between these two. Now these two question grids relates with a common logic, and we have to find out what is that common logic in that. So for example, let me tell you, if it is plus 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 and plus plus in a plus manner, and similarly here it is star 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 star, and after this I'll put some star here and square here, circle here, maybe it is we can write a triangle here, and again here it can be a triangle or else a box like square, and it can be a plus or it can be a circle. So if you look at these two grids, symbols may be changes, symbols may be different, but they have a common logic, that is they have a particular, a same type of, a same pattern here, the same pattern here also, and remaining four are different. Now in the options also we have to check the same similar patterned grids. In options, I repeat, there will be only two options which has the similar pattern. Now we have to find out those two. Just let me do one thing. Now if you look at these options, observe first grid and the last grid. These has the same pattern here, right? Same pattern as the above question. And these two, they don't have the same pattern, they don't have the same pattern. So now what we have to do is we have to click on these two. First click on this one and next click on this one. As soon as you click on the two options, next question will be appeared. Now for example, if you click on first block, first grid, and then if you click on the second grid, you will get a wrong one. Now then those options turns into red. If you click on this one and this one, those blocks, those grids turns to green. See, as soon as you click on the options, you will get to know whether your answer is right or not. Within 6 minutes, you have to click on, you have to answer as many questions as possible. As more right answers you select, those many marks you will get. But nobody has any clue that what is the minimum cutoff for this section. So you can see one more example with the same model here. Now let me explain you the second possible pattern, the second possible model in inductive logical thinking. The second model in inductive logical thinking will be like this. There will be total 9 boxes. Here I wrote only 7 because of this board, and total 9 boxes will be there, and on 9 boxes there will be different symbols like these, or there may be some stars, or there may be some other symbols like these, or else there may be some symbols like this. Different symbols will be there, and we have to find out which one is odd one, which one is not fit in this series, which one is not fit in this group. If you look at the pattern, if you look at the series, first one we have only one 0 or 1 circle, we can say 2 circles, 3 circles, 4 circles. So next one should be 5 circles, but instead of 5 we have 4 circles only. So click on this one, you will get a point. And total time period for this is 6 minutes, and I'm not sure whether there will be fixed questions or not, because I saw this symbol there. So this symbol indicates when you click on this, all the questions will be appeared. Now all questions will be displayed and you can solve any question. So there may be a fixed number of questions, or it may not be a fixed number of questions, I'm not sure, but 6 minutes time will be there. Maybe if there are no fixed questions, you have to solve as many as you can. So remember, if you click on correct one, it turns green. If you click on wrong one, it turns red as usual. Guys, remember, most probably you will get first model questions than this one, but possibility is there to get these questions also. So now enter into third section, that is grid challenge. Grid challenge is very unique, and we never come across these type of questions previously in any other examinations. Grid challenge has total 2 grids. One grid, see, this is first grid and this is second grid, but these two will not appear at a time. First this grid appears for 3 seconds and after that it disappears. After first grid disappears, then only second grid appears for 8 or 9 seconds. I am not sure whether it is 9 seconds or 8 seconds, but tentatively it appears for 8 to 9 seconds. After this 8 seconds of time period, again grid 1 appears. After 3 seconds, again grid 2 appears. After 8 seconds, again grid 1, again grid 2. Like that, grid 1, grid 2, grid 1, grid 2 appears one after the other. Now what happens here? See, on grid 1, you will find inactive dots, okay, but whenever you know first grid appears, out of these dots only one dot will be highlighted. See, these pattern can be anything, you know, dot can be anywhere. I am not sure about the those dots, they will not be in symmetric order, okay, so they will be arranged randomly, and out of these dots one dot will be highlighted when it appears. Now and it looks like this. Now after 3 seconds, we have to remember which dot is highlighted. And after 3 seconds, this grid appears. Now what is this grid? We have to check whether this grid is symmetric or not. I'll tell you what is symmetric. If you observe, this is splitted into two parts, right? And here, see, total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Total it is 8 by 4 block, we can say. And some dots will be highlighted like this with a square symbol. Now we have to check whether this pattern is symmetric or not. What is symmetric? When you fold this total grid in, when you fold this grid, these highlighted dots should be overlapped each other. Now, in one word, we can say the second part should be mirror image of the first part. If second one is mirror image of the first part, then we call it as symmetric. If not, it will not be symmetric. Now, here I mentioned one symmetric arrangement. See, these two will be overlapped. These two overlaps, two overlaps. For example, in the same case, if the grid is like this, okay, let it be like this only. I mentioned one extra grid here. Then if you fold it, it will not be overlapped anywhere. So then it is not symmetric. Now at the bottom, here it has two options called no and yes. Now we have to click, if this is symmetric one, we have to click on yes. If it is not symmetric, we have to click on no. So if it is right, it will turns to green. If it is wrong, it turns to red. But as soon as you click on yes or no, second grid appears again immediately. Okay. Now, first thing is over. And in the second round, this will be inactive and some other circle will be highlighted. It will be last for 3 seconds. We have to remember which circle is highlighted, which dot is highlighted. Again, another symmetric will be appears and we have to check whether it is symmetric or not. And we have to click on yes or no. And it stays for 8 seconds only. After 8 seconds, again, this appears and it will be inactive again and some other dot will be highlighted. Okay, it lasts for 3 seconds only. Now here we have to remember which is the pattern. And here we have to remember whether, you know, we have to check whether it is symmetric or not. After this, again, 8 seconds, we have to click on yes or no. Like this, after 3 successive repetitions, you know, first grid, second grid, first grid, second grid, first grid, second grid, first grid, second grid. Total 3 times they appear consequently. And after that, this grid appears in a big screen. So let me do like this. It appears in a big screen. The same pattern. Now all the dots will be inactive and we will have total 15 seconds time for us for this 15 seconds. Within these 15 seconds, we have to recall all the patterns and we have to click on those. We have to click on those dots which appeared in the order. So do you remember? It appeared first, it appeared second, it appeared third. So we have to click on first block first, second, third. If this is exact pattern, you will get a point, otherwise you will not get the point. I don't know, I know, I'm not sure whether it marks will be given in terms of points or in terms of stars or anything. I don't know, but this is the pattern. So let us see this video to get clear idea on the grid challenge. And the last section in game-based aptitude test is motion challenge. The time period for this section is total 6 minutes and I am not sure about number of questions. But this section will measure your ability of planning ahead. And we are very much familiar with this model. You can see a screenshot here. The motion challenge has a grid of 6 by 4. In this, we have a red ball which we have to take to the destination, and in between we have so many obstacles, a colored obstacles. We have to move them aside to make a clear way for the red ball to reach the destination. And here the thing is, here our goal is to move these colored blocks in the less mouse. Just watch this video, you will get clear idea. And you observe, the at the upper part you will find time moment also. Each question in this section is called as a level. So first question, if you complete first one, level one completes. As soon as you complete level one, level two appears. As levels getting increased, difficulty also increases. And the final round in the written assessment test is behavioral competency profiling. We call it as psychometric test, and in this platform we call it as ADEPT-15. And nobody has any idea about how many questions will be given or else how much time will be given. But if you look at the title of this section, ADEPT-15, that 15 may indicate the number of questions and maybe number of minutes that we get to clear the test. This behavioral competency profiling test has total two statements, and we have to grade them based on your perceptions. Remember, there will be few questions and there is no right or wrong answer in this section. For example, I'll give you a small example for this. If you look at this question, there are total two statements and you have to select, you have to give more priority to the option, to the statement which is comfortable for you, or else which indicates your behavior, or else which you feel as correct one according to your behavior with respect to organization. So guys, if you want to get more questions about this, you please ask your TPO sir to conduct a free webinar in your session, in your college. So that's it guys. Hopefully you got clear idea on the pattern of Capgemini 2021. Right, so if you like this video, please share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe our Aptitude Adda to get more updates about the other company patterns also, and register yourself with Aptitude Adda, and I mentioned the registration link in the description below, and all the best. Bye bye.